Canadian Football League Week 1 underway.
Oh, my goodness.
Last night's game in Winnipeg ended 20 minutes ago. After numerous weather delays, Edmonton got the victory in. We have three more games on the sked. Manziel Watch is on in Calgary tomorrow night. Here to break it down for us is Justin Dunk of Three Down Nation, joining us from the University of Guelph. Justin emailed me earlier today and said, you must call me the greatest player in the history of Guelph football. I am doing that now. Justin, welcome to the show. How you doing, brother?
I'm well, but that's a bold-faced lie, Sid. You know it.
It's true. I lie all the time about stuff. All right, let's start with last night, man. How tough?
O'Shea, Walters, Perry, CeCe.
They're all very good, and they're all texting me right now. Justin, what is that like as a football team for night one to end at like 1 a.m.? Okay, we get it. There's so many. What does it mean last night to play that long a game with so many delays? Like, who did that really hurt the most last night?
I felt like it hurt the Eskimos because they were off and running after Mike Riley hit Darrell Walker for a 101-yard touchdown. And what it did was enable Chris Strevler, Swoon, Timmy and I, to go look at some film in the locker room and get comfortable with what he was seeing. So I feel like it benefited the rookie QB the most.
There is always talk about quarterbacks heading into the CFL season, especially with Johnny Manziel here. It seems like there's even more. Before we get to Johnny football, there are some big-name quarterbacks, including the one the reigning MOP who went toe-to-toe with our boy Chris Strevler last night in Winnipeg. Do you think Mike Riley put up some ridiculous numbers last night? He was really good again. But do you think these contract situations may play a factor as we look forward this season in the CFL?
They really could. Mike Riley and Bo Levi Mitchell, the last two CFL MOP winners, are free agents at the end of the season and have varying situations because of their age. Riley is in his 30s, Bo Levi Mitchell not quite. But if Mike Riley keeps putting up these kind of numbers, and if the cap goes up next year with the new CBA, he's going to command a heck of a lot of more money than the $500,000 or over $500,000 he's making in 2018. And Bo Levi Mitchell, if he keeps continuing to have the win-loss record that he has and maybe gets another Grey Cup, he could get an NFL look, guys. So there could be a bit of a carousel going into next season for 2019.
Justin, forgive me. I know you have the Tim and Sid logo on the scoreboard there over your right shoulder.
He's got connections.
He's got connections. Yeah. I'm also fully expecting one of those seagulls flying around to take a dump on it when we're on.
Yeah, there's a lot of seagulls there.
Right? Yeah. Only if the script plays out perfectly, Mikhail.
Yeah, we can only hold
it. We can only hope. So we'll see by the end of the
we'll
second
see.
What
I'll
happens.
Let you know.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, tonight, Argos and Green Riders. Argos defending Grey Cup champions here. Your feeling about football in the market of Toronto coming off that title, what has it done? Like, can they sustain some of that excitement that we saw at the end of last season? What's your general take?
I feel like they can just because of MLSC. Everyone's getting on the love boat, as Jim Pop said, and a championship always helps, fellas, as you well know. But with that marketing machine there, as I said, in MLSC, I really think there is some positive movement in that market and that it's time that they capitalize on it. And I feel like that ownership shift is well in line with that for the Argos to be able to try to continue to climb possibly to the forefront in the Toronto sports scene with the other major teams.
Well, I mean, I'll tell you what, the second level teams are winning championships. Marlies, TFC, yep. Argos winning championships. How about the team they're playing tonight? Chris Jones has been mum on who is the quarterback. I think if we go to the website, we realize that Justin Dunk may have been right. Are you expecting Zach Collaros all the time?
Totally. And I've known since Monday, Timmy, and it's kind of funny to me. Maybe Chris Jones doesn't read anything or even know what the heck Twitter is, or maybe Three Down Nation. But anyways, it's going to be Zach Collaros. He's the guy they're paying $430,000, gave him over $200,000 up front. The Canadian, Brandon Bridge, Swoon again, got only $40,000 up front in terms of signing bonus, around $150,000 in hard money, what they call in the CFL. So it's going to be Collaros out of the gate. That was obvious to most people. So expect him to step on the turf first when that Riders offense comes out at Mosaic Stadium.
Tomorrow night, Hamilton, Calgary. Obviously, Manziel is getting talked about a ton. But there's a guy back in Calgary's fold here, Timmy and Justin, that I think Bo Levi Mitchell is very happy to see. Walk us through that storyline, Justin.
Oh, my goodness. Aaron Rodgers. So he leads the CFL in receiving in 2015, over 1,400 yards, 10 touchdowns. Gets a contract with Chip Kelly when he was the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers. Kelly loved him, even going back to when he worked him out in Philly. Got fired, landed with the Niners, signs Rodgers, but he tears his ACL. That training camp with the 49ers has been out of football ever since, had surgery on his torn ACL by world-renowned Dr. James Andrews, and is now fully healthy. So Bo Levi Mitchell gets his number one target with the guy that he's been most comfortable over anyone in his entire career back in Canada, and I feel like they're ready to light it up and potentially help both guys get an NFL opportunity at the end of the season.
Yeah, it'll be really interesting to see if Calgary can keep Bo Levi Mitchell after this year or if he gets that shot. And listen, you only get a couple shots to go back down there and make that NFL money. You know he'll be itching to get down there and make that. I'm going to close with this at 60 seconds. I'm not the Johnny Manziel guy, but we had a conversation. I worked long enough in Hamilton to know that the most popular player in Hamilton is always the backup quarterback. Just ask Danny McManus. How long, if Jeremiah Masoli struggles at all, can they keep Johnny Manziel on the bench?
To be flat out honest, Timmy, not long. Even in the preseason game, when Jeremiah Masoli threw two interceptions early in that game, there were chances for Manziel. So they already heard it from the fans. And I feel like there's sort of this pressure around the team to trot Manziel out here. And it's interesting, when you talk to people around that team, they talk more about Manziel than Masoli themselves. So if I'm going to read a little bit into that, I feel like possibly we end up seeing Manziel earlier than maybe we even think.
I watched this guy play on the field behind him, although it looked a little bit different when he played on that field behind him. There's no checkerboard behind him, but he was lighting things up with Nick Fitzgibbon and all those boys. And to see him become one of the best CFL insiders in the business, it's great to see. Justin, always a pleasure catching up with you, my dude.
Thanks, Timmy. Appreciate the love. Cheers, Sid.
Yeah, I love you too, just so you know. It's not just him.
Well, did you do any of Dunks games?
I did. I did a couple Dunks. Actually, I did probably his highest statistical game, so whatever. It's no big deal.
No problem.
I'm just good luck to the Dunk world.
All right.
Dinks and Dunks. And thanks for the scoreboard thing, dude. Seriously, yeah, that's great. Nice. We appreciate it, man.
It makes us look big time.
That's nice.
Trying to share the love, boys. That's all.
Justin Dunk doing a killer job with Renown Nation. Thanks, brother.